Good afternoon, everyone. This is Christy from Van Aan & Company. It's Wednesday, April 3rd. I'm going to go over the markets with you for the day here. You had very quiet trade into the corn and soybean market as there's just not a whole lot of news out. Tomorrow we get export sales. Hopefully this boosts this market, gets things turned around. Corn slowly bouncing off of its lows here, up 1.25 on the day, while soybeans found some slight negativity, down just over a penny on the day. Wheat markets, where you saw a lot of big movers here. Minneapolis wheat getting hit once again. It seems like you are completely wiping out all weather premium that has been built into Minneapolis wheat off the fact that the extended models aren't calling for as much moisture moving through the Dakotas. And with some normal temperatures, people are thinking that maybe this isn't going to be as late as people were expecting for spring wheat, and you shouldn't have problems getting it planted into soil with a lot of moisture around. And so you're wiping out that premium right now, getting a lot of selling pressure, over 7 cents lower on the day, while you had Chicago wheat come back here, up 7 cents. So Kansas City wheat kind of stuck in between the two of them. Over to the cattle markets, some slight negativity there, nothing too big, major, waiting on some cash trade to see where that comes in. But you did have the second day in a row, deferred hogs finding quite a bit of support, over $3 higher. So a lot of positivity when you look at those markets. Outside markets didn't really do too much. Pretty decent and quiet for the majority of the day. So what we're going to look at moving forward, definitely export sales tomorrow, especially looking into the hog market, even seeing if China pops in there for a large amount once again. And then also if we can get any more news on China-US trade talks. We did have China come over here to the US after we were over there last week. So hopefully we are coming into a point where we can get something concrete and have some positive news out of that. I do have to close with a disclaimer. Trading futures and options involves risk loss and is not suitable for all producers. This is a solicitation. Have a great day.